Do you think that David Bowie's cyber accessibility has eroded his mystery in any way?
No, because we'll never know who he is. We only know what he gives us to know. We never know who he is, so we don't know David. We don't know him. We only, whatever he presents to us at that moment is what we know. Whether it's Ziggy Stardust and White Dude, you know, the Hours persona, whatever he does at that moment is what we know, so he changes all the time.
I mean, we're calling him Dave, we're giving him nicknames. If you read on the post boards, they got all these little stories and whatnot. He's being portrayed as human, really, as opposed to the mystical rock star that he once had. I think by showing, we're all becoming friends with him as opposed to acolytes or something. I think it's definitely changed.
Do you think that's a good or a bad thing?
I really reserving judgment. I mean, I like my rock stars to be these deities, you know, these inaccessible, you know, talented, you know, pseudo gods. But at the same time, it's nice to feel like you have some connection with him, and it really creates a stronger connection to know that he's human and that he has these feelings and that, you know, what you're receiving from his music is something that he's felt himself and he has given.
Just talk through what this is exactly.
We just decided to do a little card for him, just like that spur of the moment thing, especially since after he lost his voice, we decided little encouragement, hi. So we got most of everybody in the line up till 5 o'clock, so we're talking, I don't know, a couple of hundred people signed this multiple page card that starts with a cover.
And these are all characters that are actually here, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah,
there's Posey, there's Helen, there's Dave, of course. I tried to do the whole band for once.
Right.
Usually Sterling isn't there because he's behind his drums and I never see him. But we got most people. Yeah. Waiting. We got a lot of people in line that were very, very happy to be able to say a little something to David. Even total strangers. This year there's some unknown man off the street. I was here at 4 o'clock this morning.
Eccentric guys?
Yes. Got here at 10.
10
this morning.
Is there anything about your fandom that you feel others might find eccentric?
I like his feet.
Yeah?
Yeah, great feet. Great feet, Dave.
I used to be in this band in the 70s. Matter of fact, I did up all those records. Now my student is playing the gig, and I'm playing percussion.
I presume when you're into the look of David Bowie, if you get a news picture of Ziggy you haven't seen before or something, you go, wow, that's a great picture or whatever, yeah? So has your interest in the way David Bowie looks ever made you question your sexuality?
His suit was designed by a technologist and a fashion designer, especially for the Flyer Man. Flyer Man is a man who hands out flyers.
I'm so nervous tonight, you have no idea. You just don't know. A lot of you, unfortunately, were probably victims of Saturday's cancellation. I'd never, ever in my life have woken up the next morning after a show. Absolutely zilch. So do bear with me. I am going to ask you to join in a lot of the choruses, because I can't... That sounds like a scam, doesn't it? Oh yeah, Bowie, yeah, he's like so manipulative. But it really would help something if I just drop out. Fill in. Everyone a minute. So I was going to say, I had it all planned, as I was going to say, hello everyone, and you would say, that was interesting. I want to hear you say, hello sailor. Hello everyone. You made an old man very happy. Okay. Enough falling around. This one goes back. Say now. Waiting for time was running wild in Indian streets. Every time I thought I got it, need it was not so sweet. Then I turned myself to face me, but I never caught a glimpse how the others must see this baker. I'm much too fast to take the test. Changes. Didn't want to have to be a different man. Changes. I just wanted to be a better man, but time may change me. I can trace time. Change their size, never leave a stream, form a permanence. All the days float through my eyes, but still the days never seem the same. And these children that you spit on, as they try to change their worlds, they're immune to your consultation. They're quite aware what they're going through. Changes. Tell them to grow up and out of it. Changes. Looks like you've left them up to their necks in it. Time may change me. I can trace time. Holly Palmer on vocals over there. Little M. Griner right there. I like you too.
We like you too,
we
David.
Love you.
You see, he's so manipulative. All right, I must be crazy. You know what? I must be really like wacky. Kind of really zany. Crazy to try and do this one, but we have a go anyway. Here we go. It's a god-awful small affair to the girl with the mousy hair. And a mommy is yelling no, and a daddy has told her to go. But her friends are nowhere to be seen as she walks through her sunken dream to the seat with the clearest view. And she's hooked to the silver screen,
but the film is a saddening bore, for she's lived it 10 times or more. It's about to be lived again as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. Take a look at the law man beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if he'll ever know. It's the best-selling show. Is there life on? Workers have struck for fame. Dear old Lennon's on sale again. See the mice in their million hordes, from Ibiza to the North abroad. Rule Britannia is out of bounds to my mother, my dog and clowns. But the film is a sad reward, for I wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be ridiculed as I ask you to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at those cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. Take a look at the
Carson and Pierre. You know, one, because I really want to play these shows for you, and two, because they're a warm-up for this thing in Britain that we have called the Glastonbury Festival, which I'm doing next Sunday, God willing. And I did the second festival ever in 1971, believe, and I've not done it since 1971. It's probably the many reasons being, I got on at 5:30 in the morning in 1971. I spent the whole night in the farmhouse, Worthy farmhouse, with two singers, both very talented, Terry Reed, I don't know whether you know, and Linda Lewis. Oh good, we got stoned out of our gourds, because there was, you know, I left my bottle of tincture there. I wonder if it's dry. I must go down to the sea again, the wonderful sea and sky. I left my bottle of tincture there. I wonder if it's dry. See, I can rap. duh. Thank you, love. And I got on stage around 5, that nobody was awake. And it was just me and this electric Woolworths organ that I'd bought for about £7. And a guitar. I couldn't see the notes, and I was awful. I did
dreadful show, and this Dutch girl came up during the intro to Oh You Pretty Things, which was a very new song for me at the time. And she joined me. I mean, she didn't know the song. She just sat next to me. Oh yeah, oh you pretty man. Boy, it's a pretty day. It's pretty. And she did talk about interpretive dancing. This girl, oh pretty, crack in the sky. Yes, love, love. Anyway, those are my few memories of Memory of a Free. I don't know why I'm telling you this. Oh well. So we suddenly zoom forward to the 80s, and here's something. This is one of my favorite songs that I wrote in the 80s. I really, really like this one. To take. I'm an absolute beginner. But I'm absolutely sane. As long as we're together. Rats can go to hell. I absolutely love you. But we're absolute beginners. With eyes completely open. Nervous on the side. There's nothing more I need.
absolute beginners. And if my love is your love, we're certain to succeed. If our love song could fly over mountains, could sail over heartaches, just like the bells. If there's reason to feel all the hard times, to lay down the hard lines, it's absolutely.
that was nice. Hello, Bowienetters. We've got one Bowienetter came all the way from Tokyo, and so I had to introduce her. This is Eri Wild. Thank you so much, Eri. Are you having a good time?
Are you having a great time in New York, Eri? Tell the people.
Hello, everyone. Probably most of you all have already known through chat room or message board at Bowienet. Yeah, I'm known as a girl with green glasses, and I'm also known as a girl who's supposed to be wearing China dress here. But there is one thing that nobody had expected. I had not, you know, I had known anything about this program, you know. I never expected it. I'll be on the stage with David.
Thank you so much, Eri. I hope you have a great time in New York. I'll chat to you in the room soon, yeah? Yeah, okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you. We also get stuff like this. This is somebody did a few of these. Rogue's Gallery of Chat. So not only do I chat with you now, I actually have to look at you. I got all these little... These cameras are like so cool, aren't they? I mean, you just like... Are these the same one you got, girl? These...
My...
Oh, it's M. Oh, it would be M. You kind of just like peel it off. And, you know. Good though, isn't it? It's lovely. I'm going to do my bedroom out there. A couple of walls of that. Maybe I won't. Thank you for these things anyway. It's like show and tell. We don't have that in England. I've always wanted to do show and tell, so now I can do it. Like,
this is something that I found in my daddy's drawer on the weekend, and I'm not sure what it is, but here it is.
Carry the news.
Sure white snake. space boy. You're sleeping now.
Your silhouette
so stationary.
You're released but your custody cold. And I wanna be free. Don't you wanna be free?
Do you like girls or boys? So it's confusing these days. And I swear I'll cover you
This chaos is killing me.
Hello, Gailey. Oh, it's been a long time, isn't it, love? Oh, thank you. Good night. We can be heroes. ever, ever. Well, what do you say? I could swim like the dolphins. Like dolphins can swim. Oh, nothing will keep us together. We can beat them forever and ever. I said we can be heroes just for one day.
Oh, put on your red shoes, dance the blues to the song they're playing on the radio. While color lights up your face, sway through this room to an empty space. If you say wrong, I'll run with you. If you say hi, we'll hide. Cause my love for you would break my heart in two. If you should fall into my arms, trembling like a we'll be right back.
thank you so much for helping me get through this. It's been an absolute joy. Really look forward to the next party we met tonight. Thank you so much, Tom Dolby, for joining us out here. You know that we won't see you again for about a year, but this is a lovely memory to have. And remember, I'm afraid of you Americans. But I really, like, love you. That's so weird. No checks at the wheel.
No one needs anyone, they don't even just pretend. Jonas and America. I'm afraid of America. I'm afraid of the world.
Jason.
Did you have a good time?
Yes, this is my 37th time seeing him, but I really am only 20.
Awesome. Come here.
What do you think? All right?
Yeah.
Yeah? How many Bowie shows you been to?
First Bowie show I saw was 1976. This was way better. Great band, best Bowie show ever.
Great show. You know, we dug into images there, a couple of 65 songs, made my night.
He said he's coming to Africa on the next world tour.
Right, so okay.
We haven't seen him
there. Good stuff.
We know his wife's on the continent, and we'd like to have him there.
Tune tonight, man. Good tune.